energy which was generated by this phenomenon called punk. Most of the energy seemed to involve the cameraman and the audience there, but we saw Glen Matlock on bass guitar. Glen, what is your answer to what has been said by Jonathan about manufactured music?
Well, I agree with Noddy totally about what Jonathan had to say, but I also agree with Bob here, because to me the 70s can be split into two separate groups, really. It was up to like the mid-70s with all the glam thing, and then the punk thing came along, and we was just trying to get like a back to the 50s almost thing, that the freshness and the energy of rock and roll without all the crap that went with it.
Oh, but come on, Glenn, it wasn't you. You were puppets. Malcolm put the Sex Pistols together. It was great music, brilliant records, terrific display on stage. It all worked wonderfully. But you were just playing the part.
No, but you know that if you're going to have to sell something, you've got to have something good to sell in the first place.
Oh, I completely agree.
Well, we had the real bare basics there that was something that could really be believed in. And I think that's today by bands like the grunge bands and all that, just cite the Sex Pistols and all the punk thing as major influences on them.
No, I think it was great record, it was a marvellous time, but my argument is the people behind it were people who are now just about reaching their 50s, like some of us.
Well, possibly so, but I think what we did, actually, as young kids who are quite astute, was realise that these people could help us in our quest in putting our music in front of the live audience.
I think both points are valid. There was a lot of stars created out of the punk movement, and terrific too, but it was the people from the 60s who were behind it.
Well, what about Epstein was beyond the Beatles. They would have never broken through without Epstein.
Yeah, but at least he was a 60s person. I mean, the people behind the 60s bands were 60s people.
Not all of them.
Now, Chris Miller, I met you in your persona as Rat Scabies, of course, of the Damned, and we had a nice cup of tea, as I recall. You're busy still, but what was the reason for the sort of repulsiveness of what you did and all the spitting and all that? Was that part of youthful expression and fun?
Well, I don't know about, you know, why people did it, but I do know that the one thing that was important about it was the fact that any of the current stars that were around at the time, the people that were regarded as highly talented musically, which were like Emerson, Lake and Palmer, Yes, Genesis, those kind of guys, you weren't allowed to go and spit at them, shout at them, and what's more, you couldn't stand next to them at the bar before a show. These guys, they can all talk about their great life and Jonathan King and the Archies and Johnny Reggae and Slade or Mudd or any of those guys, but the real thing, none of that was mine. That was the previous generations. And when it came to like being in the Damned and being like in a band, that was like my generation speaking. That was my own voice. I didn't need to practice in a bedroom for 15 years to go and play in a pub full of people. And that was kind of what we were about.
There was, of course, one particular incident involving the Sex Pistols that really grabbed the headlines. Afterwards, their name was on everyone's lips.
Now, I want to know one thing.
What?
Are you serious, or are you just trying to make me laugh?
Go on.
Really?
Yeah.
No, but I mean about what you're doing.
Oh, yeah.
You are serious?
Mm.
Beethoven, Mozart, Bach and Brahms have all died.
Spares, aren't they?
Really? Oh, what are we saying,
wonderful
sir?
Wonderful people.
Are they?
Oh, yes, they really turn us on.
But they do.
Well, suppose they turn other people on.
That's just their tactic.
It's what?
Nothing, a rude word. Next question.
No, no. What was the rude word?
Shit.
Was it really? Good heavens.
And that was followed, as history showed, by even ruder words. The headlines were extraordinary. The Sex Pistols are sent packing, said the Daily Mirror. The Sun called it a filthy show. And Bill Grundy said, I did it to show they are just foul-mouthed yobs. So now, Glenn, was it a deliberate setup?
Not at all. We was rehearsing to do this thing called the Anarchy Tour. And as I understand it, we only got the show at the very last minute because Queen had pulled out. We didn't even want to do it, actually, because there was this limo outside and we thought, well, we shouldn't really be seen in this big Daimler. So he wasn't going to do it. But Malcolm turned around and said, well, if you don't do it, you don't get your wages this week. So he was in the car like a shot. And It took us about 5 minutes to go from the front door into the thing, and we were recording straight away, so there was no way it was set up whatsoever at all, and as you can see from that clip, that Bill manufactured the whole thing, really. I think the whole thing with John just backing up what he said was that it was a no-nonsense approach, and he wouldn't be pandered to or I don't know quite what the right word is, but made to look stupid in front of somebody of the older generation. He just backed himself up. And that's what kids liked. Mm. They could identify with that. They didn't want all the crap. They didn't want all the stardom and all the glitz and all the glitter. The glam rock thing was fun, but that was a few years previous. And now they wanted something new. There was a different climate in England, and kids wanted to pick up on what we were doing. We didn't sort of manufacture this whole thing. We found that as soon as we started playing, there was a whole coterie and a crowd of people who were really looking for change in the music scene, and they just gravitated towards us.
I'm pretty sure I know the answer to this, but Jonathan, are you prepared to concede any of these points?
Oh, my point is the same. I thought punk was a marvellous time and lots of great music. Was it manufactured or was it natural? I thought it was manufactured. They say it's natural. Fair enough. We agree to differ.
Thank you.